Good day, everyone. So for today's content, we're going to answer some of the questions that were asked to me through Facebook. Shout out to my batchmate and friend Keisha for letting me borrow her idea. So without further ado, let's answer those questions. Okay, first question. When is my birthday? So I was born on July 6, 2001. July usually is the start of the rainy season, so highlight of my second name, Rainier. So my parents thought it would be a great idea to incorporate the happenings around them. So it was raining hard that time, so that's why my second name is Rainier. Next question. How do I see myself 20 years from now on? So, or where do I see myself 20 years from now on? 20 years from now on, I hope I would be, or I see myself as a registered nurse and a registered physician. Also, that time I would be focusing more on my career, hoping if I get to a, you know, high financial status someday, I see myself donating to charities or helping those who mostly need help, and also focusing on my own family and my career, and also my building my children's future. So not only that, but also at that time I'm hoping that me and my friends would catch up that time 20 years from now on, and you know, recall the memories of the past. So next question, Kendrick Lamar or J. Cole? So as you all know, I am an avid hip-hop listener. Without these two, without Kendrick and J. Cole, I wouldn't be listening to as much hip-hop as I am listening to today. So I was introduced to hip-hop I was a young age, but I listened to hip-hop because of Kendrick Lamar, and in his song Poetic Justice there was a lot of metaphors and double entendre, and because of Kendrick he opened my mind in to more genres as well. And because of him, I tend to listen to music that has substance or has critically acclaimed reviews. So such as one of his albums, To Pimp a Butterfly. That album helped me or made me aware on how heavy racism was happening in 2015, and also how fame, money, and you know, pleasure, how money, fame, and pleasure will drive a man crazy and will drive him away from his moral compass. So I started listening to J. Cole when I was in 10th grade with his album K.O.D. With his song Kevin's Heart, I appreciated him that time because he was using trap beats, which is usually the opposite of what he usually produces. So what most hip-hop fans would say, Kendrick speaks for the soul and the mind while J. Cole speaks for the heart. So I wouldn't want to pick between these two because they represent the hip-hop scene of our generation, but I would lean more on Kendrick Lamar. So between Kendrick Lamar and J. Cole, I would pick Kendrick Lamar. So next question, how do I celebrate success? Well, for small wins or for an achievement, for achievements, for certain stages of my life, I usually pray. I usually pray and thank the Lord. Also, I tend to share those moments with my loved ones, family, and friends. Also, what I do is light a candle on our church. So that's how I celebrate success. And also, I forgot to mention, by enjoying the moment and savoring the moment. So to celebrate success, I pray or thank the Lord, enjoy the moment, and savor the moment with my family and friends, and also light a candle, and again pray. So I would never reach or achieve success without my hard work and also to the man above. So next question, do I plan on posting any remixes in the near future? So when I was in junior high, I was using a virtual DJ, so I was remixing stuff there or anything music. Yeah, so I was using that program a lot when I was in junior high, and for me that time I thought that was producing, so I remixed a lot of songs for fun. But as I grew older and listened to more music, I realized that remixing is not producing. So at this point I want to produce my own beats, and when I get the time, I will learn how to produce using FL Studio sometime or other programs. And to answer your question, I don't see myself posting remixes in the near future. So for the next question, what is or are your coping mechanisms? So for pre-pandemic, what I did was play a lot of sports when I was stressed. Play a lot of sports and also listen to a lot of music. But when the pandemic hit, to cope, I was leaning a lot more on humorous videos or memes. Po ako si Clever Dem Ganoy, at ito po ang aming performance sa MAPE. 2 years ago, I was leaning more on memes because I can play sports, and yeah, so that time I was only listening to a lot of music. And good thing that we are already on alert level 1, so I can play more sports now. But I don't have that much time because I am again in nursing school, so it's kind of hard to juggle between those. But if I find time, you know, today I usually play a lot of sports, especially basketball, also listen to music, and to also immerse myself with nature. Recently I've been hiking. It's been one of my favorite activities the past few months. So to cope, I listen to music, play, being physically active, and immerse myself with nature. So let's proceed to the next question. So what does a day in the life of a student nurse look like? Expect a lot in your day, expect a lot of quizzes, a lot of information loaded into your brains. Also a lot of return demonstrations, a lot of case study presentations. It may vary depending on your schedule, but for me, last week was pretty hectic because last week was our submitting of our recorded return demonstrations, and that time, not only that, but you also have, let's say last week Monday, I had to wake up early and review my learning materials. Also prepare for the classes that we are going to have that day. And not only that, we're going to also prepare for our return demonstration. And then, not only that, that time last week, we were also having our quiz for parenteral administration. Just pretty difficult. And usually, that time I ended really, I ended at the 8 p.m. and I ended 8 p.m. last time for my recorded return demonstration. And not only that, once I already submitted, I had to review immediately for the next demonstration and also review for quizzes for other subjects. So a lot of time management and prioritizing tasks are required. So in a life of student nurse, well, I just tend to go with the flow and not get carried away. So I hope I answered your question, and I'm sorry if it's not structured, because it depends during the schedule or the task that I'm going to tackle that day. So next question, Queen, ano po business nyo? So mind your own business po. That's my answer. Next question, why did I choose nursing? And what factors influenced you in choosing this course? So when I was in the junior high, senior grade 10 and grade 11, my coach during that time was a nurse in our local hospital, and I opened up to him that dili ba kapoy ang paghimog nurse, kanang becoming a nurse, dili pa siya kapoy, and also coaching us in playing basketball, siya na kapoy jud siya, especially kay like he was coaching us for free that time. And he also mentioned that if love jud nimo ang usa ka butang, imo jud na pangitag paagi. So he loved playing basketball, and also he loved nursing. So that's one influence. And he also, or everyone that I know who is a nurse, mentioned that if you want to proceed with being a doctor or being a physician, being a nurse or enrolling to nursing is a great pre-med. That's what they say. Enrolling to nursing is a great pre-med because you are immediately immersed to the hospital, immersed directly to the patient, and also the subjects that you are taking is usually you have a general background on those subjects that are to be tackled when proceeding medical school. The next question would be, what is your greatest breakthrough? The fact that I am studying in Negros Oriental State University, and my course is nursing. That's my biggest breakthrough. That's my biggest breakthrough in my life so far. Because not only not everyone can be a part of this course and in this program, because out of, let's say, hundreds, almost thousands of students, we were cut down to 80, and now our population is slowly decreasing. So I hope I can make it. I can graduate here on Negros Oriental State University one day, finishing up BS nursing. And for me, that is my biggest breakthrough. So for the last part, wala ko'y question, pero butangi ka ng murag Sunday content vibes ni Umar. So I'll make this brief as possible. So by the way, si Umar, or is Joseph Sabelio on Facebook. He is a social media influencer. He posts videos, funny videos during the weekdays. Pero every Sunday, wholesome yun na yung content. So, I'll try. I want to talk about setbacks and failures. And how, it's an important issue. So, kanisha, off the top rin na topic. Because in nursing school, kaya nyo ka na daghan yung kay kang setbacks. And I have friends na kung hagbong o certain subject. Yeah, di ako mention. So, listen yung siya na subject for everyone. So, I would like to tackle on that topic. Setbacks and failures. When we hear those, nandiyan siya yung negative connotation. Yung nandiyan, ay, like, hagbong kani lang. Ang tanga sa tabaho. Magtutukan gali ka dahil yun. Ngayon, mungan sila na wala, kanang nakabuhat ka or kanang wala, kanang napalpak ka ani. Mo, kinit yun na ilang mata. Nagin yun na yung ugat ng pitik, no? Muna yung karaan mindset. Pero guys, I want to remind you na having setbacks or failures, it's really important in our lives. Maraan na siya. Sa piano, unay lang ingon na work sa piano gali. If white keys ang good times or ang good moments in life, black keys are the setbacks, failures, and kanang bad moments in our life. So, imagine if black keys are usually the sharps ata na or flats, kana sila. If sige ra ka play og white note at some point mo blend yun imo ang kuan music. Well, if imong adan og kanang sa ni black keys na ay kumbaga more colors na yung music, mara siya kinabuhi pod no. Like, we do not expect life na kuan, life is easy going, life is really hard for everyone, especially these days. Life is really hard for everyone. And having a setback or failure is really important because first of all, mag-push yung kagong kuhaan panikamot. So, labi na nagkuhaan, nandiyo tayo kailan no, na mga mindset nila kuhaan pa kanang derogatory gali o panulti if like naki-setback. Ngayon na sila na, la, ni si kuhaan kani-kani siya, kuhaan siya, hagtong siya, buto ng bata, inganap mo. Ako, kung gana i-remind you guys, one failure does not define who you are, no? So, mag-push yung ka, tungod ana ilang mga comments, or tungod ana yung expectations na wala na-fulfill, gana yung achievements na wala nabot, mag-push yung ka further na maningkamot to achieve what you want or what you need, no? So, kana dayon not only para ma-push ka to work hard, pero kuan it makes you work at your own pace. So maybe kuan nag-setback ka because kuan you were following someone's pace, no, which usually happens to most of us. Kaya kanang labi na lang sa mga kuan school works or kanang mga ingangaon sa mga if bisag may yung tag la, wala ko eh may yung hala, wala ko eh wala ko eh idea pero dapat na ako ni submit so dapat magsigi ko kuan, magsigi ko lingkod ra iri, pinanguna ko anything para makasubmit lang. Well, in fact, if may yung tag working at your own pace means like, in kato na context when na kay idea, pinili mo na siya gamitin dayon. May nga na ba? So like, being at your own pace means na kuan, you can decide on what really matters in your life, no? So, kuan, setbacks are a major factor in that play pod in kuan, that play sa pace sa imuhang kinabuhi. So, dili jud ko mo remind jud ko ninyo so na having a slow progress is still progress. Diliin siya toxic positivity, pero maod yun na siya. Although you might think na false, kanang mga false hope gali or anything, toxic positivity ba na, pero if naad yung kay progress, bisag hinay, considered as progress yun na siya. Motoy, natoy saying na like, 1 times 1 is equal to 1, while 1 times 1.1 is equal to 1.21 or something. Hangtod sa magka-build up ni mo na imong pinakagamay na progress, hangtod sa mahimo na siya habit or kanang may manapod siya lifestyle, then ma-kuandun ni mo siya, malampasan ni mo na siya na setback, which setback gatabang ni mo pambuhat ana. And then lastly, setbacks and failures give color to your life. Now, as mentioned, as to my analogy kanina, piano keys, no? So, kanang white keys are the good parts of your life, while the black keys are your bad parts of your life. So, mura po na siya sa atong kinabuhi. To sum it all up, being, having failures does not mean you are already a failure. Greatness is defined. Greatness is not only seen on what you have achieved, but it is mostly seen on what you have done behind your achievements. Okay, so that's it for my content, everyone. I hope you enjoyed watching my content for today, and God bless everyone. Thank you for tuning in and stay safe.